Sometimes, women in their reproductive years may notice a red or brown spot, which leaves them thinking whether their monthly period has come too soon, or wonder if their period even ended. This scenario happens to many menstruating women, leaving them feeling utterly confused. In this video, we'll go through some of the different characteristics of menstrual bleeding versus spotting. Let's begin by first explaining what a period is. In non-pregnant women, menstrual bleeding happens generally every 28 days. The uterine lining thickens every month to prepare for pregnancy. The uterus sheds its lining if a woman does not conceive, which results in a monthly menstruation. It may also be called a menstrual period, menstrual cycle, or menses. In women who are in their reproductive years, menstruation usually occurs monthly from puberty until menopause, which marks the end of menstruation. That is, when periods have stopped for 12 straight months. Menstruation normally stops during pregnancy. Spotting refers to very light vaginal bleeding or brown discharge that occurs mid-cycle between menstrual periods. Spotting is often harmless but can also be an indication of a problem that warrants attention by a healthcare professional. For instance, in cases of sexually transmitted infection, or uterine fibroids. It can occur between periods, during pregnancy, after sex, or after a gynecological exam. But how do you tell the difference between spotting and periods? Noting the timing, the duration, and other relevant details can help determine the difference between spotting and periods. I'll go through each of these characteristics and details. When we look at the timing, menstruation usually happens around the same date every month. That is, the length of the menstrual cycle varies from woman to woman, ranging between 21 to 35 days, but the average is to have periods every 28 days. On the other hand, spotting can happen unexpectedly, often irregular, but may coincide with ovulation. When we look at the duration, periods last around 3 to 7 days, but this also varies from woman to woman, while spotting has no consistent duration. The bleeding pattern varies for every woman but usually starts light, gets heavier for 2 to 3 days, and gradually tapers off, while spotting has no consistent pattern. When we look at the blood color, menstrual blood alternates from light red to bright red to brownish, while spotting can be brownish, pink, or reddish. The consistency of menstrual blood is often fluid mixed with coagulated blood. The consistency of spotting is variable from greasy to sticky to fluid. The cause of bleeding in period is the uterus, usually shedding of the uterine lining. While spotting can be triggered by several underlying causes, including upper reproductive tracts like the uterus, lower reproductive tracts like the cervix, vagina, and vulva externally. Symptoms of period may be related to hormonal changes that may cause cramping, bloating, and breast tenderness, while symptoms of spotting are attributed to the cause of spotting. For the management, period products like tampons, pads, period panties, and maybe painkillers are required to manage menstruation, while spotting is easy to manage and does not require period product. Pantaliner or leak-proof underwear is enough to manage spotting. What causes spotting? Spotting may be caused by one of these factors. Ovulation. An egg is released from your ovaries during ovulation, which takes place in the middle of your menstrual cycle. When ovulating, some women have mild spotting. Pregnancy. There may be some spotting or light bleeding 1 to 2 weeks after a fertilized egg implants into the uterine lining. During pregnancy, it is also possible to experience spotting or light bleeding following sexual intercourse. A pap test, which is a swab of the cervix to check for abnormal cells, and during pelvic examination. Polycystic ovary syndrome. Infertility issues and irregular menstrual cycles can both be brought on by polycystic ovarian syndrome, a hormonal condition. Due to an irregular ovulation cycle, individuals with PCOS may suffer abnormal vaginal bleeding like spotting. Ectopic pregnancy. This is a condition when a fertilized egg develops outside of the uterus, usually in the fallopian tube. It's one of the causes of spotting. Birth control pills. Spotting can be brought on by birth control pills, especially when you initially start taking them or switch to a different type. Breakthrough bleeding is more likely to occur with continuous birth control than with 21 or 28-day pills. Spotting occurs frequently in women who use an IUD as well. Uterine fibroids or polyps. Small, non-cancerous lumps known as fibroids can develop either inside or outside of the uterus. They may induce spotting between periods and other irregular vaginal bleeding. Other causes of spotting include infections, cervical polyps, menopause, and injuries in the genital area. When you suddenly start bleeding or spotting without warning, it might make you feel anxious and stressed. Don't assume the worst if this is happening to you. Keep an eye on what's happening and decide if you need to consult a doctor. And that's all for this video. If this video has been helpful, hit the like button, share it, and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching.